It handles immortal Messiah. We sing, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, and He shall reign forever and ever and ever. And the chorus ascends into magnificent praise unto God Most High. It said that Handel, when he wrote the Messiah, was caught up almost in a heavenly rapture for 21 days. He did not eat, and he wrote feverishly this magnificent piece of music, considered perhaps the very finest work ever composed by any human composer. What was it all about? It was about Jesus as Lord, the Messiah, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Now, the Apostle Paul tells us something about Jesus as Lord. The first thing we have in Romans 10:9 is the Apostle Paul says, if you will confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Now, this confession is the only way of salvation. It is the key to salvation. People say, well, I have received Jesus as my Savior. Well, Savior is one half of it. The other half is to receive him as Lord. And unless you confess him as Lord, Apostle Paul was saying no man can confess that Jesus is Lord but by the Holy Spirit. This is a supernatural work that says, I, a human being created in the image of God, yield my spirit to you, Jesus of Nazareth, for you are God. Now that's what that says. And I have given my total allegiance to you. You are the Kurios, the Lord of my life. And that is the confession that brings us salvation. Not saying, I believe Jesus died for me. Yes, he died for you. He died for every human being on the face of the earth. But it's those who confess him as Savior and Lord who know what it means to be born again. Now, we might ask, what are some of the proofs that Jesus is Lord? And there's so many. He overcame disease. He overcame demons. He overcame death. He overcame raging storms. He overcame all adversity in his own life. He overcame death, and he triumphed over the cross. He has given matchless proofs that he is the Lord, and not only Lord of the world, he's Lord of all, but he's especially Lord of the church, whom God hath made the head of the church, his body, which is the fullness of him that filleth all in all. We are the fullness. The Greek is pleroma, the swelling, the fullness of him who fills all in all. Now, before Jesus left, he gave something called the Great Commission. Now, this was his commandment to his disciples that they would go to serve him throughout the world. And in this Great Commission, he said, all authority in heaven and earth is given unto me. Now, the term authority is exousia in the Greek, and we translate it power, but he has authority over all. So in the Great Commission, he says, I have all authority over demons, over angels, over principalities, over powers, over rulers, everything. I am the head of all. I have all authority. Go, therefore, in my name and teach all nations. Now, the Bible also says this, that Jesus, in his last days when he was being questioned in his own trial, he said, all the tribes of the earth, excuse me, this is the Olivet Discourse, all the tribes of the earth shall see the Son of Man coming in the clouds of heaven with power and great glory. And when the Son of Man comes as king and all the angels with him, he will sit on his royal throne and all the earth's people will be gathered before him. In his trial, He said, you will see the Son of Man coming in the glory of his Father. He is King of Kings. And as we read Revelations, he is King of Kings and Lord of Lords. And all the earth will see him. He will come in glory to put down evil and to establish righteousness. He will come mounted, if you will, on a magnificent white charger, and the angelic host will be with him, and the host of heaven and all the redeemed will come with him, singing, "Worthy is the Lamb to receive riches and honor and power and glory, King of Kings and Lord of Lords."